Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Let's Play Minecraft. So, I have to show you these. This is the most beautiful, coolest thing I've ever seen. Listen. Isn't that amazing? Okay, so let's turn down the sound just a bit again. So what's going on here? How did you get these going without blah blah blah? If you guys have been yelling at me, I'm sorry. I do pre-record these a few episodes sometimes. Anyways, you break the chloris fruit itself just like this, and it drops. You don't actually need to go around and break the bottom of these because they won't work. If you break the bottom of this, you will not get that fruit or the flower. But you will always get the flower if you punch it directly. Yeah, that makes a big deal. Now, I don't know if the materials drop from the flower when it goes shooting up in the air. I think it might. So you see how there's two of them on there? I think that's how you get them. But I'm not 100% sure, you know. I'm new to all this. But either way, I found out that's how at least you're supposed to, or at least for me it seems, to get the flowers and then be able to plant them. And then you can listen to them do their music. I wonder what happens if I stand on it and it grows. I wonder if you can bone meal them. Probably not. Is my food acting up again? Maybe not. Something's iffy with it, I think. Let's put this away. I want to try something here. Oh no, I don't have bone meal here. I want to know if it pushes me up like a piston or not. Or if it won't go because I'm standing on it. Good luck figuring out what that was. Weird, huh? Do I have my growth rod on me? No. Maybe it can't because I'm standing on it. Maybe it's just bad ticking, like I'm getting very unlucky. They seem to at least grow once by now, but I kind of wanted to know, would I clip through it? Would I fall? Would it push me up somehow like a piston? Has a bit more magic to it, you know? But oh well. Anyways, so I've been working on this. I extended this a bit, and I got a lot more of these going here, so I'm happy about that. And so let's collect this. Got 56 of the brick we can do right now, the greenhouse ones. God, that feels so wasteful. Just because they can be used for greenhouses, I guess. I've never made a greenhouse. It's a new thing in forestry, but still. Makes me kind of sad doing this. So we got the dragon fruit, which I'm happy about. Where did we put it? There you go. So I kind of want to do that today, actually, for sure. Not just maybe, but definitely want to do that. So we want here, and no, actually, want to figure out how this works again. Modifiers. Glowstone, redstone, and gunpowder. The downside is I'm almost out of glowstone, sadly. I haven't been doing the best with that, but whatever. Glowstone, redstone, and gunpowder. You know, I should probably just keep some with us, like, because if we're using this all the time, right? It's like, what the hell was that? It's the stuff converting. Okay, so I think what you're supposed to do first is put the fruit in. Then we can put the redstone, glowstone, gunpowder, put all this on here, And then you can go ahead and make your normal recipe, of course. So my favorite one was ended up being probably the growth wand, right? Some of the other ones didn't work. Ender Warp sounds kind of cool. I don't think I want this, but ability to teleport forward even through walls, blah, blah, blah. That's actually not so bad, actually. Maybe we have to try that. Huh, maybe we'll look into that. Anyways, the one I want again is the growth one either way, because that was my favorite one. If I could figure out where the growth one is. Oh, here it is, growth. Lilac. Oh, no. Lilac is actually somewhat a rare plant that I haven't really farmed or gotten many of to begin with. Okay, I don't know how we have that, but we have it. Okay. So we gotta get the vine beets, blah, blah, blah. Oh, my mom. I'm bringing some tortellini soup, although I'll bring some tortellini noodles. How does that sound? I'm pretty sure this store is still off. Sounds good. Okay. Just email my mother. It's important. Sometimes you need a, you know, you guys have to just hold back for a second, you know, so I can email my mother. Okay. Oh God, I'm gonna make some of that over time. Beets, beets, beets. The more we eat, the more we know that's beans cane. Beets, beets, beets. There we go. And then the other guy, I think we have other guys in the other guy thingy. Yeah, we do. I'm really excited for this to try out one of these staffs, see if it actually works the way I think it is. I think that's how it works, but I don't know. I think it's a replacement for the wood, but I'm not 100% sure. So boom, 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 and then boom. That so did not work, Kane. Oh, you're an idiot. You put it all in the wrong thing. Okay, we kind of failed all that badly. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Oh, no, this is to make the spell. Oh, no, this doesn't work. Oh, no, 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 this is the spell part. You're an idiot. You are an idiot. Okay, so I think I got this now. I was an idiot. Big time. There we go. So there you go. Awesome. Then we can put this in here. I feel like it was more to this. Okay, we gotta look up this part, because this is where I forget now. This is where I'm pathetically failing at this again. Blah, 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 blah. That's Imbuner. Magic staffs are very simple to use. Imbuing the power of nature. All you need to do is hold right-click and charge up a spell after about a second release. Right-click to cast it. Blah, blah, blah. Modifiers, Terra. You know, more fine pestel, use the spell, but can't really use this in natural energies. Place in a stick, place in your powder, and wait for your staff to pop out. Oh, no. I thought this is how you put the staff in. I don't know how to use the crystal staff then. I guess there's more to it than I realized. I thought that was it. So that's how to make it. Adding spells to the staff requires a separate ritual. In addition to the ritual, display components, you may add up to 4 additional petal dust as an incense. Each of these will be added to the staff, overriding previous spells if necessary. Simply sneak and right-click to cycle through the staff spells. Oh, that is so cool. Up to 4, right? So the essence burning. I think I get it now. I might get it. So we need to make more, or attempt to make more. So let's put the staff here. Let's put whatever. So we'll put this here. I don't know if this is really gonna work. And then your root here. Since we don't have much, we'll give it a go with what we have now. Oh crap. Oh crap. I think I did it in time. Oof, we did. So look at that. Look at that. So that crystal staff is way better than what we had before. There you go. But it gives you an idea. And you can do a better effectiveness, blah, 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 blah. You guys get the story. But that's how you do that. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Let's put that staff away. And it charges over time? Or I might be confusing on that one. It sounded like the staff would never end, but I might have misunderstood that. For too long, the number of uses in your terminal using a rare crystal from the new, you believe you have created a way to boost the efficiency of your. Okay. Not only the staff boosts the use of the counter spell, but it also hold up to 4. Okay. So it boosts it. It doesn't actually. Okay. So you can hold up to 4 spells, which is awesome. And then you can rotate through them. It's not infinite in any way, but that is freaking cool either way. So that is that, my friends. Okay. So here is the daisies. Hello, daisies. Oh, shoot. So we can go that. We could have done that spell again, actually. The essence is, incense is burning. I didn't realize that. But what did I put? A staff? And might be too late to do this, but it might be worth it if I can. Oh, here it is. Still going? Oh, darn it. Thought that was it. Oh, it's out now anyways. Huh. Maybe I needed to put the staff in first or something. I don't know. Or maybe it was smart enough to not let me do it a second time. Who knows? Oh, I'm an idiot. The stone was gone. So I should have done it on multiple staffs. So this is actually really worth it. Because if I did that, did all 4, then did like 4, 5, 8, 10 staffs, I would have been powerful and have a lot of those uses and everything for a very long time. So keep that in mind. That would have been awesome. But either way, we failed. But we've learned. We've learned. And that's what counts, right? So I guess I should do this so I can make sure I can get those back easily. Yeah, we do this. There you go. We don't have enough outside of that. Okay, so Batania again. Batania, Batania, Batania. We're going... Oh, here's these guys, by the way. I was wondering what happened. They got auto-looted in the bag. Batania and... okay. So learning the basics, blah, blah, blah. We've done this all, I guess. I don't know why... Okay. That's weird. Did we get an achievement then for this, or no? I don't know, to be honest. Make generating flower. Okay, so I guess that's it. We're back to our own then. I guess the first thing we want is mana pool, generating flower, all that. So mana pool, blah, blah, blah. You make it out of the living rock normally. Don't know what it's going to be like in this one, so let's try living rock and see what happens. Funny thing is, mana pool is a mana pool, so that's kind of cool. Let's go ahead and I guess we can place this wherever we want for now. And we need to give it some pyro of some sort. Living slab, diluted. So this is, oh no, that's diluted. We made a full mana pool. If you make the diluted one, it's weaker, not worth it. I think we could throw it in a mana pool, but I don't think it's worth it. And then it shows you the things you can make, of course. Mana Master. What is this? The impression measurement of the wind sometimes won't tell you, turning your profit loss in your mana bonus. Create a mana and place it next to your pool. We'll have it shine red if there's a loss, or if there's a loss, or blue if there's a profit. The measurement happens every few seconds. Oh. Light Scion, red and green. Light Scion, red and green. I think that would be sort of it. Intrigued by it anyways. Should probably move this over here. There you go. Bucket, here we go. Boom, and then there we go. So boom, 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 boom. Oh, there it is, and boom. So you can place this beside it, I guess? So nothing's happening, so maybe it'll just stay as that color, and then it'll change when we start, you know, firing something to it, of course. But that's something new. I don't remember that. So we need to give it some mana. Mana pool, mana spreader. The mana spreader is the most important component in the mana. This block allows mana to travel from point A to point B. This allows you to place on the ground till blah, blah, blah. And there's your spreader. So we're going to have to make this spreader. I don't know if they changed it, of course. So we're going to have to double check the recipe here. Wild wood bark symbol. Wow, it's good we saw that. We need flint and gold. Jerks, jerks, jerks. It's so hard to see that too, but yeah, I noticed it. And then let's get some flint. Where do we put all our flint? We have a huge thing of flint. Where the hell do I put that? Oh, in here, I guess. No, yeah, there you go. And hopefully I still have wild wood. That's living wood. Wild wood. There you go. Okay. So wild wood and a piece of flint should give us da-da-da. And then living wood. Oh, no, that's not it. That's not it at all, was it? No, it wasn't. Mana spreader. Oh, crap. Okay, that's what it was. The bark, wasn't it? Yeah, okay. There you go. Then the symbol on that one. Okay, there you go. And then living wood, and we're doing something wrong. Oh, and one random flower of any kind. Oops. So, bark, living wood, gold, and there we go, the mana spreader. Now, this used to be easy. I forget how to do it these days. I think it, yeah, that's backwards. So, we want to point it the other way. We could put it kind of close. We'll probably move all this over time anyways. And then you get it provided a flower of some sort. I think when you first begin, not 100% sure, you can only do one kind of flower for power. And then as time goes on, you can do other powers. But usually it's a little easier on this, but I think it tells you where to go normally. But the quest all failed on me, so... Ah, there you go. Britannia Lexicon. So here's the Britannia book. So we've learned that. Here talks about the flowers and the petal and all that. We've done that. Then the Apothecary, which we've done that now. The Pure Daisy, which we did last time pretty much. The Wand of the Forest, we haven't done that yet. So there's the Wand of the Forest. It might be slightly different than what we're used to. Who knows if they changed any recipes. But Wand of the Forest, here it is. 1, 2, 3. And actually, I think it was just, yeah, it was straightforward. So mine's not pretty. Changing these changes the color, which is pretty cool. And this lets you actually do things like right click and connect this, or you can, you know, change it around. But there you go. So it's pointed right to it. It was kind of already pointed to it anyways, but lets you change things. It also lets you give information like where it's hitting, things like that. Okay, so we go back here, we go back here, we go to manipulation and reduction of mana. It's basically mana pools, etc. And then it talks about the mana pool, of course, and what you can make with it. And then we go to mana spreader, which of course we've made. And then it would like us to use an introduction to generation. There you go. And Endoflame. Are you actually recommending an Endoflame at this? I thought you couldn't do an Endoflame. I thought you needed glow. Mystical brown, mystical light, mystical red. Wait. Are those... That is the new ones, I think. Mystical, aren't they? No, they're all called mystical. Huh. Brown, red, and gray. Brown, red, and gray. Brown, red, and gray. Brown, red, and... Ooh, please be a light gray. Light gray. This is a bit different than I remember. I didn't think it was this, but I don't know. Times have changed. I thought you had to, like, you had to light these up in a way. Yeah, this is going to work. Yeah, this is a lot different. Before, back in the day, what you would have to do is you would have to make one of the renewable ones first before you can do that. So that has all definitely changed. So that's pretty cool. I wonder if these values stick with these, like, whatever. But anyways, basically this, you feed it coal, and it should work. This is a modded coal, so it might... No, it works. It should be the same idea as, like, whatever is accepted in the furnace burn should be accepted in this burn. And there you go. And there's our mana pool being generated. So there we go. We're finally already doing Batania. So did this go blue? Did that actually change colors? Oh, there we go. Vivid Wave. Wonder what that achievement is. I like that. Thank you. Craft the mana pool and store mana. Cool. So if we... I want to see what this does if I threw it... Oh. I want to see the what was said on here again. Because that's a cool flower. Oh, here it is. Huh. It's showing blue all the time, but maybe that's because, you know, it's beside the pool right now. Or not beside it, but what it was last. It said shine, right? But I guess we'll see later on, right? Either way, very cool. So what are we up to? We kind of screwed up the instructions here. Introductions and functions, so it tells us, you know, functions. Back. And runic altar. Oh, the runic altar, that was fun to make. Are you hard these days? Let's see, runic altar. See what you are these days. Oh, roots, what is this? I need to learn how to make a leaf. Everything else is fine, but that leaf is something new, so... you can put, by the way, because, I mean, we can store a lot in here. You could go, you know what? How much can that store, actually? That should be a decent amount. Can we see any? No. They're still respecting their things. I thought maybe some mod would kind of overread it. And let's do that. There you go. And that way. There you go. So you can do, yeah, coal block, whatever. Let's go ahead and read the roots and figure out that. I think I've seen that leaf somewhere here. I have never made it, though. But I thought I saw it one time. Ah, here it is. Flowing through you. You have come to realize that life force of this world is not entirely self-contained. Your energy has to be coming from somewhere, right? You have come to believe when you channel life energy, your purpose... purposes per opposes you are and actually drawing a small amount of energy from a strange energy field that permeates living things that you have dubbed the overworld. You are still left with questions, however, the exact does this plane affect the physical world you live in, and what else is there to know about? Using advanced rituals, believe you may have able to tap into the field directly, but you do not know what you will find on the other side. What the? Okay, so another world. Ritual lessen the gap between our world and the other world, allowing small creatures to pass through. Wow, that's cool. We don't have those pillars yet, though. The ground slowly become darker, attacking again will destroy the spirit's physical form, but you believe there be a meaning to healing them back. After destroying a lesser spirit in the world, you may notice it drops several strange leaves. Okay, so we have to do this ritual, basically, but we need those pillars. And that's not going to happen right away, because I think there was a reason why they wouldn't. Actually, they might now. What are these called? Standing stones? Stand by me. Stand by me. Oh, you just suck balls. Ash, really? Ash to make that? Anyways, 16 ash. Let's get our 16 ash first. Now, this isn't supposed to be grind one. Oh, look at all those. Nice. Grind like a million whatever. It should allow us to get this pretty easily, to be honest. Yep, there you go. So we got the 16 of those. And then mana. Please don't be steel. Iron. Okay, so we need, four? No, why is your math wrong, Kane? So four. Yeah, just four. You might as well get more than that, but we'll try 32, see what we get. Well, mana steel is used a lot, at least used to be used a lot, so I assume it's still used a lot. But there you go. Let's take the whole pack of them and... Oh! That sucks. If you put it in your hand, it'll say you can't do it right now. Not enough power. So now you're already starting to understand that you're going to need quite a bit over time. Yeah, so that we might want an extra flower over time. I'll upgrade or, you know, make it better. But you can already see that this is taking a little longer than one would want. That'll be fine as long as it doesn't despawn in 5 minutes or whatever. But we should be good. How are we doing for our iron here? Can we do another one now? No, not yet. There you go. Oh, so let's see how it went red. Now it should go blue again. It's a little particle effect that comes off of it. That's what it was. Interesting. Okay, so we need to get more runestone. Ash stone and the growth powder. I don't think... Oh, we got some rune stones here. But unfortunately, my other stuff is over here. I believe I put it in here. The last I used this, but I'm not sure. Ash and stone, there it is. 4, 8. Oh, shoot. Oh, no. That'll be enough. We just need 12, right? There you go. We'll just do that. There you go. So we got 3 of them. My very own henge. Get it? Stonehenge? There you go. And we'll break you guys. And place you somewhere else, of course, since also is... What the hell is going on here? There you go. Cool hitboxes. Annoying as hell, though. For me, it was annoying as hell there. You can just do that till it does it. I worry about this despawning. It's like it might take longer. Oh, we got it. That literally drained all the mana pool. That's awesome. Okay, so we can do the last one here. Awesome. And from what I saw in the book, they just sit on the ends here. Yeah, they just sit here. Oh, crap. Where on the ends? I wonder if it showed me early. Ah, here it is. You've used the standing stones to channel blah, blah, blah. Regenerate the effects of the ritual. You've created a standing stone that will perform simple purpose in the area around them. Requiring redstone power to activate. What? Ritual? You've used this channel of life and energy before, but never on their own. However, using the power within the infernal bulb and the regenerative effect of a ritual, you have created a standing stones that will perform a simple purpose area around them and definitely only requiring redstone. Huh. I don't know what those are. Attuned standing stone? Will grant all nearby creatures a speed. Okay, that's cool, but I don't care about any of that. I just want to know that if those stones that we see... Oh, these tell you all the different effects. Okay, I think this should work with this one, but I'm not 100% sure. And I don't know if it's gapped one out, two out, what. I think it's like that, but I can't be sure, to be honest. Oops. What are you doing, Kane? It's too bad it doesn't tell you if you know what's your structure at. Okay, so we will play around with this on the next episode, I guess, and see how things are going. But so far, things are going pretty good. I'm really happy about this mod. Very interesting either way. Isn't that insane how long that's lasting? But either way, please don't forget to subscribe, comment, like, and we will see you wonderful people next time.